Hello guys, and welcome to my new Let's Play of Borderlands. And I really don't think there's anything to really explain. Actually, come to think of it, for the first couple of episodes, I'll be doing it solo, just up to the part where I get my action skill, and then outside, I'll turn into a co-op Let's Play, mostly because by the time I get my action skill, I should hopefully just be done talking over all the tutorials and everything, or how to play this game and everything. But other than that, I really don't think there's much else to kind of say about this Let's Play. I'm still planning on going through with the whole thing. But with all that, we're just going to begin. So like I said, I'm going to do the first couple is going to be a solo.
Treasure hunters. Have I got a story for you, Pandora. This is our home, but make no mistake, this is not a planet of peace and love. They say it's a wasteland, that it's dangerous, that only a fool would search for something of value here. Then perhaps I am a fool, but do not be fooled by what Pandora appears to be. There was a legend. Many people tell it. The legend of the vault. My father would always go on about the vault, even with his dying breath. Advanced alien technology. Infinite wealth. Fame. Power. Women. So you can understand why some little kiddos who hear the stories grow up to become vault hunters. Well, I have a story you may not believe, but I tell you it is true. The legend of the vault is real. And it is here on Pandora. And let's call her a guardian angel, appeared to guide the vault hunters to their prize. The tale begins right here on Pandora with the brave vault hunters, the guardian angel, and most importantly, me.
Alright, so Alright, so that's pretty much the whole introduction for the game. And you pretty much saw the four characters that you can choose from. Ronald the Soldier, which is currently selected. And the next is Mordecai the Hunter, Brick the Berserker, and Lilith the Siren. So to pretty much kind of go over everyone, the little info screen, it'll pretty much tell you what you kind of need to know about the each character. The soldier, as you can see, prefers combat rifles and shotguns, and their action skills, Scorpion Turret. Ronald, to me, he's not a bad character. He's probably my second favorite or third, but that's just me. The Scorpion Turret is useful for pretty much damaging enemies, and depending on which branch you go into, you can regenerate health when you're near it. The Scorpio Turret can do more damage to rockets. It can replenish your ammo when you're near it. And I think those are kind of the main points of the Scorpio Turret. The next one is Mordecai the Hunter. And his preferred weapons are sniper rifle and revolver. And his action skill is Bloodwean, which is, well, pretty much what it kind of suggests. It's pretty much a bird. And you can kind of see a little bird above his head. Mordecai, for me personally, I really don't like him. That's my personal preference. Some people might agree or disagree, but that's, I'm not really fond of him. Bloodwean, I really don't even know much about Bloodwean in all honesty. I mean, I'm pretty sure with Bloodwean, he has increased damage when you use it. But one thing I do know for sure is there's a skill where you get more money for every time Bloodwean kills someone. But I'm not really sure because I have not played as a hunter for kind of an extensive amount of time to actually get used to him and everything. Brick the Berserker. His preferred weapons are explosive weapons and his fist. And pretty much, I believe that's rocket launchers. It's kind of put simple. And his action skill is Berserk. Most people will pretty much go for Brick the Berserker on their first playthrough. Or at least that's how it seems like when it first came out. Because he just seemed like a total badass and everything like that. With Brick's action skill Berserk, you pretty much go into rage state, and I don't think you can necessarily get damaged in it, or if you do, you can't really tell. I was never really paying attention when I went into the Berserk state, but pretty much with Brick, his action skill, like I said, you go into a rage state, and you pretty much use the two triggers in order to deal damage. And one of them is kind of a quick little punch, while the other is more of a, I don't want to say charged up, but kind of a heavy hitter, heavy blow. And for Rick, his kind of skill tree, there's an increased damage with, there's another one where you get more health, increased ammo towards, the rockets, and actually, I should take that back, with everyone's kind of skill tree, I'm pretty sure they all have increased ammo for their preferred weapons. And actually, along with that, everyone also has a skill which will reduce the cooldown time for their action skill and the length of the action skill, how long you can actually use it. But getting back to Brick, he also has a skill for increased damage, which everyone has, besides Mordecai, because Bloodwing will only attack one enemy and then come back. But for Mordecai, Bloodwing, for that particular skill, will attack more enemies before coming back. But also, Brick has a skill where you can get money for every punch you deal, or somewhat of a percentage. And then Lilith the Siren, which I'll be using, her pretty much preferred weapons are elemental weapons, which is one reason I do prefer Lilith over everyone else, because I usually use elemental guns more so than damage rate guns. And I know some people that will also go elemental guns and everything, but yeah. Her action skills, phase walk, which will temporarily make you invisible so you can pretty much escape or get close to an enemy if you want. And with phase walk, if you melee attack someone from behind, you get a bonus damage for doing that. Along with that, with Lilith and her kind of skill branch, like I said, with everyone else, there's the whole elemental, more ammo for the preferred weapons, more chance for elemental gun to actually activate, which I'll go into that later. Reduce cooldown time for phase walk and increase the phase walk duration. There's also different skills for phase walk in which, what was it? Increased damage if you attack someone from behind, and there was something else. But either way, like I said, I'll be going through as Lilith the Siren for this let's play.
Stay calm and don't let on that anyone is talking to you. Start making your way off the bus. You don't have any reason to trust me, but I need you to believe that I'm here to guide you. I'm here to help you find the vault. In a moment, you'll be greeted by a funny little robot. Do everything he says. You'll know what I mean when it happens. I'll contact you again soon.
Well, we're here. Don't worry about saying goodbye. I'm sure we'll be doing this all again soon enough. Get off my bus.
Welcome to Firestone. I am CL4PTP. You may call me by my locally designated name, Claptrap. Before continuing, please accept this echo communication device and heads-up display, provided free of charge by the Doll Corporation. Great! I detect that your echo device is fully functioning. This way, please.
Alright. So, to pretty much explain what you just got, it's pretty much your basic display. And there's... You saw the whole names for everything. Bottom left, you got your health display. Bottom right, you got your... ammunition, how many clips are inside the gun right now, and how much ammunition you have total. Straight in the center, right below the LV-01, that is pretty much your experience bar and the level. And then on top of that is pretty much your compass and your destination, but we'll be getting inside a little bit later. And if you want to, you can follow the Claptrap, but really quickly, I'm going to come over here because there are stuff that you can loot. Pretty much anything that you can open, you should probably open because there's money and ammunition. And when you first set off, you should probably come over here just to kind of pilfer some money, ammunition, since you don't get the maximum... amount of ammunition when you first start off. And if you come over here along with that, you can get an ammo crate right there. Not an ammo crate, weapon crate for a weapon. For some new weapons, I should say. So we're gonna do that really quickly. And pretty much for the basic controls, your left thumbstick controls your movement, right thumbstick controls your looking around. A is jump, B is crouch, X is to... No, I was gonna say X is to reload, but of course I accidentally fired that. Y is to switch weapons. RB is grenades, I believe. Left bumper is your action skill, but we don't get that for a while now. Left trigger is zoom in, and right trigger is fire. And select, back select, I don't care what you call it, is gonna be your display, inventory, pretty much everything for the whole game. As you can see, it shows pretty much what you need to know about your character, I guess. Your weapon proficiency, the maximum weapon proficiency they can get up to is level 50. And the benefit of increasing all your weapon proficiencies for each of these, you get... a stat boost for the weapon type and everything like that. So it's beneficial to kind of switch out between weapons, even if it's not necessarily the character's preferred weapons, but it's kind of a well. And all the way at the bottom, you see your money pouch. I don't know why I just call it a pouch. And above that is your ammunition, and it pretty much has all the weapon types and your grenades. And the top one is how much ammo you have for that selected gun, and then below it is the maximum amount of ammunition you can carry. I'm pretty sure that this whole aiminess and lines up with the weapon proficiency. But besides the Edokin weapons, which I'll go over once we actually acquire one, that's the only thing that doesn't show up in the ammo, and like I said, I'll explain why once we find one. If you scroll over with the right bumper, you have your backpack, pretty much your inventory, like I said, and off to the right hand is pretty much all your equipped weapons on these four. And then over here is your shield. I want to say that's your grenade mod. And the one below it is a class mod. The one right over here is your action skill and all the points you can use in order to power up the action skill, which I'll go over that once we get point and everything like that. The next one over is your mission log. It pretty much displays the current missions you have, what missions you have completed, and which missions you are ineligible for. But that's mostly when you go on online play. And on top of that, off to the right, it'll pretty much give you a little information about the mission, what the suggested level is for each mission, and the difficulty of the mission. And then below that, you get shows the rewards in terms of XP and money. And above the mission log, you can see it shows Y. If press Y, it pretty much gives you a little challenge log of everything you can do in order to gain more experience to help you level up. And there's quite a lot, so you should probably kind of not necessarily look at it and decide what ones you want to do, because as you play through the game, you'll probably complete a large majority of them just by playing the game. But yeah. And then the next one over is Echo Logs, but that we really haven't even got any yet, so we're not gonna bother with it. And the very last one is pretty much your map of the whole area. And yeah, you pretty much will use it to kind of get around, find kind of what's what, I guess, in terms of where vehicle, health, shots, bounding boards, pretty much everything in the little legend is. And if playing online, if someone else was in my game, if their name would appear right under my gamer tag, and then it would pretty much be the same little emblem as the gold, but it'll have a little dot under it to represent another player. But that's pretty much it for this, so we're actually gonna get on the way. And actually, if you press in the thumbstick and go forward, that's how you run. So let's continue on what we were gonna be doing on in terms of this. What you gotta do is pretty much simply follow the collapse trap. So all we gotta do simply is activate it. Pretty much the new you. For right now, all we can do is change our name and the color of our character, like so. But I'm not gonna bother doing this on screen, so we're just gonna get out. Now Aww. So messed up. Yeah, but like you said, the new you also doubles as, in case you die, you get sent to the nearest new uses activated. And why not? But about the new year, pretty much all you can tell if it's activated or not is because it's green. If it's not green, it hasn't been activated yet. It's kind of really quickly, I want to get past this so I can end the episode. Oh, yeah. Duh. I don't know if I should be happy that they suck aiming or not. Oh yeah, but when you first start out, you kind of want to be careful since you don't have a shield. So it's going to be kind of easy for you to die. And as you can kind of see, there were red dots on the little compass that you have that will pretty much signify enemies. And yeah. Pretty much how it works is that if it's kind of bright red, sort of, I guess, that kind of means that the enemy is close to you, so you should kind of look out. And then they're both repeaters, aren't they? Yeah. Trying to trick me. Oh, and also with the weapon log, you can press right trigger to separate the weapons into the weapon types and pretty much the brands and whatnot. And once we get shields and everything like that, all speed separate and shields, shield mods, grenade mods, and regular mods, pretty much everything like that. Alright, so now we pretty much don't even have to worry about the flat trap right now. Oh, and also, pressing in the right thumbstick will do a melee attack. Should have also mentioned that. Melee attack really doesn't do anything besides pretty much hitting them for melee. And except if you're online, you can press right trigger to send a dual request to someone or accept someone's dual request. Alright. Oh, that was all of them? Oh. I was supposed to say, I swear there were more beans that's out here. Oh, can't hear me. Alright. Attention, citizen. Alright, so the very second mission you get is the Doctor is in, which is to pretty much help Dr. Zed, but we'll complete that next time around. So, shut up, Claptrap. Yeah, but like he mentioned, you get a little green diamond once you accepted a mission, so it'll pretty much tell you where to go and everything like that. And as you can see, the objective kind of shimmers in green. I don't know why I said shimmer, but oh well. So that's pretty much it for this episode and kind of the introduction of Borderlands. So when we come back, we are going to continue on with the whole game and this mission and all that good stuff. So see you guys in the next episode.